Rigsters here with a recorded episode of Assetto Corsa Competition. So on this one, I'm just going to show you the setup of what I've been trying to work with on the track Donington in the dry. Track temperatures at the start at least is 23 aperture, 31 track, but I've been told that aperture of the weather is more important than track. It's just something to note. Starting off with, for the setup with the tires, I did 26.3 in the front left, 26.8 in the front right, 26.2 in the left rear, and 26.7 for the rear right. The toe I have not changed. Camber is not changed. This preset was, as the setup says here, AG stands for aggressive. This is version 2. MP1 is for the engine mapping. I was experimenting with engine map 2, which I'll be doing for this demonstration of about 3 to 6 laps, non-commentated for that part. Because unlike most cars in this game, the Acura NSX and the NSX Evo go from 1 is least aggressive throttle intake to 4 being maximum fully aggressive. The problem I've noticed is when you go beyond 2, it likes to slide very quickly because it builds up turbo pressure very fast. Another thing I have learned is with the traction control 2, and this also seems to work for the Ferrari, at least the non-Evo, I've tested on this very course, off-screen and off-camera, is despite the potential lap time lost, at least with a Thrustmaster T150 wheel, it seems to me that it does indeed keep it so much more stable. There's almost no point of going lower than, say, 8TC2 until you get really good with the car, at least with this kind of wheel and combo setup for the time being. That doesn't mean you can't do lower than 8TC2, but having that throttle cut being way more aggressive seems to actually help. It certainly helped me a lot. That may not always help you, though. So I've also kept the ABS on 2, and TC is on 3. The fuel I'm going to be using is 62, because I always test with sprint race fuel as the setup, because I don't really like testing low fuel loads unless if it's for actual qualifying. Only because with that bearing in mind, at least it can feel what the car is when it's heavier than when it's lighter. Mechanical grip here. The only thing I've changed in this setting is the brake bias, which used to be in the 50s. I've lowered it to the high 40s to put more of the brakes towards the rear. Dampeners have not been adjusted, although it is comical to see that it's all 8s. So it's 8 out of 8. The only thing I changed in aero, and I did test this with the rear wing, you can't adjust the splitter, although I have tried. Only the Mercedes-AMG, as far as to my knowledge of this game, and the Porsche, have that as an option. For the rear, I tried lowering the rear wing by 1 quick to get a rear aero balance of like 4.9, but that seemed to make it too unstable. And then when I tried 11 and even 12, that made it understeer a bit too much for this given setup. So, with that in mind, I'll now do non-commentating. Thank you.
now.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.